Now the crew from the film is about to glide up the carpet towards a brighter tomorrow, perhaps. But that, because that's the name of the film.
Vers un avenir radieux, signé du cinéaste italien Nanni Moretti. Un film présenté en compétition pour ce 76e Festival de Cannes. Avec nous, sur le tapis rouge, le réalisateur Nanni Moretti et ses interprètes Arianna Pozzoli, Blue Yoshimi, Valentina Romani, Flavio Furno, Giuseppe Sconditti, Angelo Galdi, Francesco Brandi, Michele e Burnea, Son Iyu, Daniela Malacuzo.
The crew from A Brighter Tomorrow is on the red carpet. It's a story about a filmmaker who wants to shoot a film, but he has trouble at home, trouble with his finances, and he can't move forward with his film. Nevertheless, it's a film full of hope, full of nostalgia. And Nanni Moretti, if you watch the film all the way through to the end, you'll see that there's a message of hope there, as is suggested in the title, because it's called A Brighter Tomorrow. So his film is a tribute to Fellini and other filmmakers. It's also a tribute to Netflix and other digital platforms. It's also a tribute to Korean producers and to Kazovitz and to the Blues Brothers as well. So the filmmaker is trying to merge together different traditions and Italian film. Some people like to compare him to a kind of Italian Woody Allen. So Nanni Moretti's made 16 films to date. And he's been in Cannes several times. In 2001, he brought The Sun's Room and got a Golden Palm for that. He came to Cannes in 2011 with Habemus Papam, starring Michel Piccoli. He also brought a film about Berlusconi, The Cayman. So the rumor would have it here on La Croisette that this film could really, really have an impact on the stakes for the Palms. People say it's in with a good chance of getting the Golden Palm, or so the critics say. Nanni Moretti has just been on the red carpet with all of the younger actors from the film, highlighting A Brighter Tomorrow. And then in a second wave, there will be the older actors in the cast. And there we have Nanni Moretti standing next door to Margherita Buy, who he works with practically all the time. She was in Mia Madre, and in this film, she plays the role of the filmmaker's wife. And in the film, he's trying to make a political film, whereas the wife tells him that it's more of a romantic film. Well, it's very difficult. It's hard to explain. You have to go and see it. It's released in July in France. It's already out in Italy, so it's been out since April in Italy. So we're not talking about just one film here. There are four films in total, films within a film. So the story initially about Giovanni, a renowned Italian filmmaker, who's about to make a film. But between his marriage in crisis, his co-producer on the verge of bankruptcy, and the rapidly changing film industry, everything seems to be working against him. So we may have said it a few times, but that's what we're here for this evening. How many steps are there? 24 steps. Mathieu Amalric, the French actor in this film, he was in The Diving Bell and the Butterfly. He was in The Blue Room in 2014. Barbara, the film Barbara, of course, with Jeanne Balibert. Jeanne Balibert played the role of the singer. But there were some physical similarities, I think, between the two. So here we have the whole crew from the film A Brighter Tomorrow on the red carpet. There are younger actors, older actors, and he is sure that they're all heading towards a brighter tomorrow. Mathieu Amalric and the other actors are there. Moretti has said that he took his inspiration from Fellini, amongst others. Margarita Bui is his leading lady. She was also in Tre Piani in 2021. Mia Madre, which we've already mentioned. And she was also in the Bellocchio film, Esther de Notte. In fact, it was a series. Bellocchio is also in competition here in Cannes. This competition, he brought the film Kidnapped, which was screened, I think, just yesterday. Shall I make the pitch for the film yet again? Perhaps it's a story about an Italian filmmaker who wants to make his latest film but can't. No. Let's not go down that road again. It's a tribute to the movies, and it makes us think a little bit about the Korismaki films. There are some stories about Godard. Apparently there's a play of words in the Italian title, Il Sol, could be the sun, the sunshine, which could have two meanings in this sense, because in the Italian title, it's referring to the emblem of the Italian Social Democratic Party. Well, here we have one of the scenes from the film which is being acted out there. This is why they're turning like dervishes. It's because it's a scene from the film. I'm sure this film will be a huge success. There are quite a lot of them, quite a lot of members of the cast representing the film. They turned up at the festival hall on foot. They did not come in their coach or in their bus or in cars. There they are going into the festival hall. And I'm going to leave you because I'm going to go and see the film. Well, off you go. Enjoy yourself. Nanni Moretti, 16th film. He's entering into the Lumière movie theatre. And you can hear the applause. Moretti.